The idea is to create a world where every idea is taken to the end. So when I was writing this, information technology was taking off, and I was visualizing where everything is utilized to the maximum. Every communication between humans has been capitalized. Every single interaction can be measured and calculated. And the ethics of the corporation that creates this world is exactly this, that every idea will evolve. Every idea will go to the end. And the ethics is, if we don't do it, somebody else will do it. So that's why they just do it. It's in this world, it has become irrational to fall in love in the old way, because statistics have shown that it doesn't really work. It will cause trouble. And the Lovestar Corporation has found a way to measure this in a more scientific way. Just like two birds mate for life because of the waves that surround the birds, they have found a way that how to find the two humans that actually interlock with each other. And stupidly enough, these two couples, Indriði and Sigrid, they believe they are in love in the old way, and they struggle to keep it that way. But of course, as an author, I could not keep it completely without trouble. My book is kind of a tribute to ideas. So it's a tribute to my favorite authors like Kurt Vonnegut, Calvino, Bulgakov, and George Orwell, kind of authors. I wanted to have many ideas in the book. So I always love books that have many ideas. And I think about ideas in a book like alcohol in a drink. So some books are like 5%, and some books are like light wine with 15%. But I wanted my book to be more like tequila or even like straw rum, up to 90% ideas. So after I published the book, I was grieving the book for a year, because almost every page could have become a novel. So it's like very, very thick with ideas. I was like 3 years writing the book, and compiling it in a way so the ideas would not be interfering with each other, but serving the story. So like mythology, just like the Bible, the first 10 pages in the Bible finish creation, Adam and Eve, the Noah, all these episodes. It all happens in a very condensed way. And mythology in general is very often very big ideas in a very condensed way. So I was reading that kind of literature too, to kind of create a very big story, still very concentrated of ideas and events. Not putting 500 pages on people saying blah, blah, and blah, blah. More like just the essence of the story. My book actually is written through a chaos method. So I took kind of every idea that I could find that came to my mind, just ideas from everywhere. And I put them on a big document, like 500 pages. And then the real work was bringing order to the chaos. So taking everything, making it work out, but still keeping kind of the essence of the chaos in the story, that is kind of the size and the scale of it, but still making it into an arc of a coherent story. So that's my idea of chaos. There's a book in Iceland, the Codex Regius, the Poetic Edda. And that book is the primal source of Nordic mythology. I think I would take that book with me. It's a very beautiful book.